I actually, before I started covering AI a number of years ago, I did a lot of consumer tech coverage and and a lot of wearable coverage, actually. That was like a big part of what I did. So I'm going to say it's possible that they're working on something that is like a device that you'd have in your home. So maybe some sort of speaker thing. I like that. I could see that. Or something that would go in your ears, you know, some sort of earbuds. Possibly something glasses related, but that is really, really, really tricky. So many companies have tried and failed at that. Anything on the body, I'm going to guess probably not, unless it's a super, a category we're super used to seeing, like earbuds or glasses. Like, I think one of the problems with the Humane Pin that has bogged down a lot of other wearable companies in the past is it is so hard to get people to wear something on their body. You know, ignore how well it or badly it works. Just getting someone to wear something and to wear it consistently is very, very tricky.
Yeah, like, do I want to walk in a bathroom with a clip on me that like has a sensor or camera on it?
I know.
Seriously.
But I don't. Most wearables, and especially like jewelry like wearables, I remember a number of years ago, people were trying to push those. And it is just so tricky to get people to change habits, you know, and to get used to putting something on all the time. What if it doesn't go with your outfit? What if it makes other people uncomfortable? There's a lot of things to think about. But I do think it's interesting that they're thinking about what could be like the next device category. I'm really curious if it's going to be something that we hadn't even like considered. But I guess we'll have to wait and see until sometime next year.
It's funny you mentioned glasses and Apple. Mark Gurman just out with a story, 10, 15 minutes ago about Apple aiming to release smart glasses at the end of next year, part of a push into AI-enhanced gadgets, but it has shelved plans for a smartwatch that can analyze its surroundings with a built-in camera. Does Apple need to be worried about this collaboration, Rachel?
I think potentially over time, it's sort of unfortunately and not satisfyingly, it is sort of it remains to be seen because they've been super cagey about what they're even working on. What is the prototype of? Like what exactly did OpenAI buy? It is not 100% clear to me. And I don't know if anybody even really knows. So, and I think they're trying to keep it more secretive than a lot of their other efforts. So, we'll do our best to endeavor, to find out what's happening. But we might not know until we know.
Well, something we do know is that Anthropic is finally rolling out those new versions of its Claude AI software, including a long-delayed update to its high-end Opus model as the company vies to stay ahead of a crowded market. We're talking about Sonnet 4 and Opus 4. For those at home having trouble keeping this stuff straight, this is Claude, which is a competitor to OpenAI's ChatGPT. I actually downloaded and played with it a lot over the weekend, but I'm using Sonnet. What's this and how is it different? I'm using the free version of Sonnet.
Right now. So right now they have these two new models, the new version of Sonnet and the new version of Opus. Opus is essentially their flagship model. This is the new version of the flagship. They haven't had one for over a year, actually, which in AI time is a very long time. They had released an older version of Sonnet and of Opus and yet one more model that they have. And these are all the different models that power their Claude chatbot. And this was like last spring. And then they released a couple updates and they said an update to Opus, the most powerful one, was coming, but then it never materialized. I spoke to the company about it the other day. I spoke to Mike Krieger over there at Anthropic, and he said that basically what happened was they didn't feel like the model they prepared, the version of Opus they had prepared, was like better enough than Sonnet, which is a slightly less powerful model. A lot of people use it for coding. They didn't feel like it was like differentiated enough, so they decided to hold it back. What they have now is they feel a better model.
I shared with Shireen earlier this week on our air that because she wrote about Claude and a big profile of Dario Amodè, the CEO and one of the founders of Anthropic, that I discovered Claude Sonnet, the one that I was using, was disconnected essentially from the web because I asked it a question and it told me it couldn't answer because its training stopped in, I believe, October of 2024. Does Sonnet 4 mean that its training goes later, like until like March or April or even May of this year? Is that how it works?
That's a good question. I'm not sure for these two when they were trained up until, but probably it would have been trained until more recently. But yeah, that's a good question. I'm not sure exactly when. However, what they do have is these models, they can access the internet, especially in certain cases. What they can do is a thing called tool use. So they can use other software to help answer questions. So if you ask a research question, let's say you have a bunch of different medical symptoms that you're asking it for help, trying to brainstorm what the problem could be, and you want to use, it's got like an advanced, like a lengthier quote-unquote thinking mode, and so you want it to use more compute, spend more time going over a problem, it could also go onto the internet, for instance, maybe look up some medical papers and sort of bring those things in. So yeah, it does have access to the internet, but in certain ways.
That's a good point. I just asked it while you were talking. Excuse me, forgive me. My reliable knowledge cutoff is the end of January 2025. This means I can answer questions about events and information up until that point, but I cannot provide reliable information about anything that happened after January 2025.
Full disclosure. Rachel,
for that, you can come to me.
I love it.
We will. So,